I could probably and probably will try to squeeze in a little amount of time, a lot with you, because since we met at CMW for the last couple of years, we've followed each other, we've talked to each other, we've messaged each other, we've probably done everything you can social media-wise, and when you do get a chance to come to Toronto every once in a while, we do actually get a chance to get together. You have such an array, an amazing bunch of things that are going on. I mean, the first thing I should say is happy belated birthday. How did the birthday
Thank
go?
You. Well, you know, it's the pandemic going on, so, like, it was super chill. I just had a nice dinner with my parents, and we watched them, like, TV shows and stuff. So, yeah, pretty relaxed, I would say.
That's the other thing, the pandemic, because, of course, I'm speaking from Toronto, which is a hot spot. You're speaking in another hot spot, which is Montreal.
Yeah.
How are things going there? I mean, you hear stories, but, you know, unless you speak to somebody who's there, you never really know what's happening. How are things happening in Montreal?
Well, I think I don't live on the island of Montreal. I'm just a little bit outside of it. We're still in, like, what we call the red zone. I would say, like, you know, everybody's kind of, like, trying to figure this out. I'm obviously working from home for a lot of stuff. But it's, you know, it's, I think it's the same in Toronto. Like, we're all in a red zone. We're trying to figure out how to manage this whole pandemic. In the same time, we're still lucky to have like a home and like a place to stay and watch TV. So I'm like, you know, me, I'm more on the positive side than on the negative side. But for me, I feel like, of course, this pandemic is horrible for a lot of people. But like for me, if I'm saying like, if the way that I can help is to stay home and watch Netflix and work out from home, I mean, that's not a lot that, like, that's not asking a lot from me. You know, it's just like, it's trying to do our best to help society, you know, get over this.
But you did something too during this time, and I don't want to give too much away, but not only did you create new music, and congratulations on that, we're going to talk
Thank
about
you.
That, but you moved from one place to another place. How the hell did you do that during the pandemic?
I guess, even though I'm respecting like all the government's rules and stuff, I was still a little bit nervous because I was staying at my parents. So I moved out of my parents' place, but I was just a little bit nervous because, like, if I, for example, I have to go to studio, like a grocery store, and somehow I would, you know, give this to my parents, I would really be ashamed. And, you know, it obviously wouldn't be my fault, but until I was too stressed out to still live with my parents while this was going on. So I guess it was just like timing wise, you know, as you said, I just turned, like, it was my birthday yesterday. So I just turned 28. So I guess it was just like, I think I was ready to move. And then this happened. I felt more secure to not, you know, put my parents at risk every time that I would see them. And I was just like, okay, so let's look like what's out there. And I just bought my place. So yeah, I 2020 has been a horrible year for many people, and that's why I keep it on the low, because I feel like on and on, if you look at everything that's happening this year for me, it's a pretty good year.
You know, it has worked out that way for some people, but
yeah.
You know, as I know you, you are a very outspoken person. You don't hold back. So I'm curious on your thoughts on the things that have been going on around the world lately, especially out in the U.S. As we speak, you know, they're on the eve of an election. The things that have been said about a certain president, and I'm not going to go too much into that.
Yeah.
But, you know, the fact of racism is being spoken and shown in a whole different way, plus the fact the terms Kevin and Ken are new terms and strong terms, and the things that we see. What do you think about all of this, and has it affected you in any way?
Well, it didn't affect me in any way because, as people know, I'm a white woman. I have a lot of privilege, so my condition obviously hasn't changed. I think it was necessary. I think 2020 forced everybody to pause, to pause their lives, and now people are starting to think and reflect on, you know, how we were going with our lives wasn't probably the best thing right now. So I feel it was this year was necessary on many levels. I feel like, of course, Black Lives Matter. I mean, I'm going to say it. You know, I've been very, very vocal about this. I feel like as a now graduated law student, like, I cannot be silent about this issue. I mean, I have to be, like, the best ally that I can be. As you know, I've always been, like, in for diversity in all types of aspects in my life. Like, for me to have a diverse cast, a diverse team, like, I've always been really in sync with this issue. and aware of my privileges and how I can help people. So I feel like I've done that for the past couple of years, but I'm now happy that this is really a political like priority right now. Like this is enough. Like this racism has been gone for way too long, and I'm glad that now white people are like feeling ashamed and guilt, because that's how you rethink how you're living your life, what, you know, impacts others around you, and you have to just make changes. That's not even like an option. Like Black Lives Matter, Indigenous Lives Matters, like we have to take steps and action to help these people, because like we as an ally, I need to help them in any way that I can. So like I think this was necessary for sure.
Absolutely. One of the things I remember you posting was you talked about how somebody, you know, a Black person that you knew younger actually helped you personally, because another thing that you are very outspoken about is body imaging. In fact, just recently you had an incident happen where somebody said something inappropriate to you, and you made it clear that, you know what, back off. This has nothing to do with you.
Yeah, it's, you know, I mean, I have a body type that's probably more popular because the Kardashians and the Nicki Minaj of this world. But yeah, I feel like, you know, growing up as a white woman, I was surrounded by white, I would say, stereotypes of what a body should look like. And I was trying to hide my booty, I'm just going to say it, and hanging out with women from the Black community helped me to really love myself and love my body, because I think at this point, like I think it was like 10 years ago, I just realized that, you know, beauty is in the eye of the other person, that in that there aren't like just one body type that is acceptable for society. So yeah, I was like, for this post that you talked first, I guess I just wanted to say to people that, you know, the Black community has been influenced, like has influenced us in so many ways that probably most people are not even aware. And I was just like showcasing how, like, even for me, who is like inspiring other women to accept their bodies, like this is due to the Black community, the way they open my eyes to the different beauty standards. And as for the other thing that you said, that people just said that I should cover up, actually I was wearing high-waisted leggings and like a hoodie, and of course my booty was showing in like this old baby boomer white male, of course, just said like, you should cover up, like you're asking for it, and blah blah, like awful stuff. But yeah, of course, like I guess I think I'm happy in a way that I know how to reply to these people. So I guess I would much rather have them say to me and I can like educate them than other people that wouldn't probably have the guts to, like sometimes it's scary, like nobody knows how to react to these kinds of comments. And I guess I lectured this old man, white dude, that, you know, this is inappropriate, you cannot say these things. And yeah, I just schooled him.
Well, let's hope that these people do get educated and, you know, keep their own business and be respectful to women, or not just women, just people in general, because that wasn't needed at all. But what is needed is great music, and you've just released a new single. I saw all the congratulations up last week. And this is, I don't even want to know if I should say it's a different style, but you've been leading into, I think, slowly from what I've known you from before to what's going on now, there really is a different sort of texture to your pop, R&B, even some techno in that too. Yeah. What's the new single and what's it about, please?
So my new single is called Obvious, and yeah, you're totally right, actually. I wanted to take a little bit of time off to just reflect on how I wanted my music to go, and I wanted like what I wanted to say. And I felt like I've always been, you know, always been this boss B word, like, you know, being really outspoken and out there, and, you know, don't F with me. And, you know, it's kind of like a boss attitude. And then I'm still the same boss. It's just that I felt like I feel like with this year, people needed positive vibes, and even me. So I was like, okay, I just want to write positive music because I'm a genuine happy girl. Like my mom always says that it's easy for me to be happy. Like some people just like have everything more easier in terms of happiness, and that's me. I just find the positive side in everything. And yeah, and I went on like this date with this guy, Cole Style. So we kept our distance and we talked for like 3 hours, and we just, we clicked, and it was, it has been a long time since I felt like butterflies in my stomach, and you know, all the cheesiness with, you know, that goes around love. And I just wanted to write about that. I wanted to write because it was the first time in a long time that I felt happy about love. Now here I stand before you, slowly dancing. You know there ain't no party out before you. Oh, got me crazy. I kind of like it. You know, with everything that's going on, like, I think that's the, like, just, that's just the sign. Like, I need to write good vibes music because I need this for myself. I need me to remember that I have to keep an open heart for future beautiful experiences because I've had my heart broken a couple of times, but I still want to keep this hope in me. So I was like, I'm going to write this song for me first and to talk about my experience, but then hopefully it's going to be good for other people.
It is great to hear, and congratulations. I don't know if you want to say anything more, but I'm assuming this is still going on. Can I ask that?
The what, sorry?
Can I? No, I was gonna say I don't want to get too personal, but is this still going on? And congratulations on the new relationship.
No, it's not a relationship.
Oh,
so yeah. So this is the thing. Even though like it started great, like I'm not in a relationship.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm still single, but it's just like I wanted to write about this experience. I don't mind saying it, but no, I'm still single and ready to mingle.
Well, you know what, like I always keep saying, and you know, we've messaged each other, you single is a crime because you're an amazing young woman, and
Thank you.
You know, all the things that you do. But one thing that I you know, I was actually thinking about this, should I ask about this or not, but you're very open to these things because you said it to yourself that you're like, no, I don't hate guys, but my music tends to go to how dumb they are. Can you talk about that?
I just feel like when I talk to my other girlfriends, I feel like I've always had the worst anecdotes and the funniest stories. And I feel like maybe that's, you know, because I'm the songwriter, I feel like this is why these kinds of situations happen to me. Because I'm just like, this is why I've had like the funniest stories and like the weirdest one, because I can write about them and put them into songs. I just feel like I you know, it's we could probably have a podcast over like the dating life in general.
You should do one.
I'm thinking about it. A lot of people told me that because I tend to talk about pretty much anything in life because I'm just really curious in general. But I just feel like I don't know. I think I'm a lot for guys. I think that I'm really intimidating. Not to sound pretentious, but it's just a fact. And it's just like, I feel like guys don't know how to deal with me. And I know we've talked about this, and you're like, you need to go for older guys, and you're probably right. I guess like I have to go like above 35 or something at this point. I'm just like, I think I'll go for a dad. Just like,
and I've said to move to Toronto. Those are the two things that I have said.
Yeah. That's the two things. Yeah. So unfortunately for now, I'll stay up for a couple of years probably around Montreal, but I, you know, once this whole thing is over, I'll for sure gladly be back in Toronto. I just love this city.
Well, we're looking forward to you coming back here. What advice then can you give guys? I mean, you know, because we're coming up to holiday season. A few months from now, it'll be Valentine's Day. You know, around holiday season, people tend to hook up because they don't want to be alone. And then after the holidays, you know, you never know what happens. But what advice can you give us? Especially the guys who, I don't know, maybe we just don't get it. What's the advice?
I feel like, first of all, communication is really the key point. Like, you have to voice where your intentions are. Like ghosting people isn't a good idea. It's never been a good idea. Don't ghost someone. Just, like, oh, grow some balls and say if you're interested or not. I feel like this is the biggest problem. Like, we don't want to have confrontation. So we tend to like not say anything and just go away, but that's not respect. Like, and so it goes hand in hand with like communication is key. And like, even though the person that you're seeing, even though it's a guy or a girl, you're a guy and a girl, I don't mind. It's like the person in front of you, this person like deserves respect. So like, communication is key. Give the other person respect. Even though you're not interested, it's still a human being that you have to respect. So I would say like most of the time I feel like I don't get the respect that I ask for. So then when you don't respect me, I tend to be really angry. That's how I'm just someone who's going to cry a lot, but I will swear a lot if you disrespect me.
Do they know that you, you're a black belt?
No, but now they will do.
So guys, be smart with her. You don't want to be on her bad side, whether it be musically or physically. So
yeah. Now you... I'm going to sound like I'm part of like a mafia or something. She's going to kick your ass.
Yeah, well, if you are, then you're going to be the queen, so they need to bow. So. But just recently, too, musically, you did a performance for your new single.
Yeah.
I think it was Canadian Beats.
Yeah.
How was that?
It was super fun. I feel like, you know, you've been also one of, like, my biggest and first supporters for my solo career. I feel like I'm always going to be more generous towards the people that just gave me a chance. So Canadian Beats was also one of the first one that, you know, helped me with my solo career. And when when we talked about, you know, this new single, the team was just like, hey, like, let's just do it live and, you know, we can play your acoustic song. I was like, oh yeah, I haven't done much in the pandemic right now. So I was just like, yeah, that's fun. It'll be good for me to revisit my song and see how I can, you know, render them acoustically. So I guess it was just fun to connect with people. And I feel like because I'm writing pop music, I feel most of the time people don't really realize that I write my own music. And yeah, I write pop music, but I still write them and I'm a guitar player. So I guess it's just a good reminder to them that I'm a musician also. So I think that was just really good in all.
And the other thing too is you had a great photo shoot, and I do believe video, because for folks who haven't seen it, we're going to talk about your where to go on your platforms, but pink and cupcakes were the theme. Can you talk about this, please?
The song is really fun. It's about, you know, dating in this COVID era where, like, you gotta make it obvious that you have feelings behind your screen and stuff. And when I was talking with the team, these two girls from La Clique, which is a company in Montreal, these two girls are my friends and they started their production company and stuff. And when we talked about the whole single, I was just like, I think it could be, like, really funny to make it, like, a Katy Perry vibe where, you know, just fun. And I feel like we took the word obvious to, like, a different degree. Like, you know, we see this guy giving me cupcakes, and I seem like I'm, like, surprised, but at the same time, I'm not, because, you know, it was obvious that I was interested. So it's just, like, it's just, like, making fun, playing around the word obvious. And I was just, like, I feel like maybe it's, like, a third degree there, but I feel like, you know, the fact that I'm curvier and I'm praising body diversity, you know, because, like, girls my shape were always, like, judge if we eat cakes or whatever we want to eat. And I feel like it was just, like, you know, having fun. Like, you know, I love cakes. I love cookies. So I was just like, okay, let's just do something fun with that and making it obvious.
Well, what's obvious for folks who have known you throughout your career is great smile, but also the best hair in town. And you took a step. Cutting it. How was that for you to do? Was that a hard thing to do? Because it looks great now, but
thank you.
Wow, what a change.
Yeah, I guess my team, because, you know, I've had like long red hair since like 2014. So my team was like, okay, can you just make a change or something? Like it's good. We like it, but I think you need some, like, you know, change. And when I thought about, like, this new music chapter, I was just like, okay, I know it's going to sound cheesy, but I feel like, you know, actually it was, like, a new chapter in my music career, but also, like, in my life, you know, I just bought my place, and then I graduated law school. I was just like, I think I need a change just in general, because right now I'm this new person for sure. Like, with everything that has been going this year, I'm a different person. And I've thought about cutting my hair for a while because I just felt it. And I looked at a couple of, like, other pictures of other singers that had the same, I would say, face as me, like the same shape. And I was like, oh, I think it's going to look good. And I talked with my hairdresser, and she was like, yeah, I think you're ready, because the way you're talking, you're not hesitating. You're just like, okay, let's cut. Let's, like, here are the examples and stuff. And when I cut it, like, I just felt like it was kind of, like, therapeutic in a way. Like, I just feel like right now this, you know, my short hair, it feels more like me than the long hair. I feel like because it's, like, it's still classic, but it's super punchy and fun. And I think, like, it's just, it showcases my personality more.
Well, it definitely does. And like I said, it even brings out that great smile of yours even more.
Thank you.
Congratulations. You know, for folks who are going through everything that's happening right now with COVID and all these other crazy things, And you've been able to keep a bright light throughout this time. What advice can you give them that hopefully they can keep their light burning bright?
I feel like, first of all, with this, we just have to take one day at a time. Like, just one day at a time. Like, and to just, like, wake up in the morning. Sometimes, like, it's, you know, depression is amongst us for real. And I feel like, you know, just to get up and just even do, like, small things, this is, like, a victory in itself, because there's so much going on that the fact that you're able to just live your life, it's good. I think we don't have to put as much pressure on ourselves. And also, like, I think for me, like, just to go back on the Black Lives Matter, I feel like I've always known I had privilege. So I guess it's, like, I don't want to complain too much, but this is only for me. I feel like when you understand your privileges, it's kind of, like, harder to feel depressed, because it's like, oh my God, like, you know, I have a roof over my head, I have food, my parents are still together, they love me, I have friends, like, I have great entourage. So maybe it's just sometimes to list the things that you're grateful for. Like, you wake up in the morning and you're just like, hey, like, I slept in a bed, I have food. Like, so it, I think it's always good to put back to realistic things. Yeah, and I'm healthy, and, you know, I can move, and yeah, so maybe, like, probably write a list of, like, the things that they are grateful for. I think that would be a good advice.
I would agree with that. Before we start wrapping this up, is there going to be other new music? Is there going to be an EP and upcoming performances happening with you?
So upcoming performances, I think it's a little bit hard to say because of COVID in general, but, like, for sure, like, live performances, if, like, the first comes in, like, for sure, I'll do them. For music, for sure, I'm back in the game for 2021. So, like, I can already say that I'm going to release the stripped down / orchestral version of Obvious in January 2021. And then we're already working on another single. And I'm not going to give the punch too soon, but just look at the title of my next single, because they're going to tell a story. I think everything's going to fall into place, and the next singles are going to be in one huge story.
And the holiday season is coming up. You released holiday music before.
Yeah.
It's going to be back up again. What are those holiday songs?
Yeah, for sure. I'm a Christmas crazy lady. So for sure, like, me, November 1st, like, I'm going to start my Christmas tree and stuff. I feel like this is also something that really helps me with my good vibes in general. I just love to see the Christmas lights, and, you know, that the Christmas music is, this is something that makes me really happy. And yeah, so Home for Christmas is my single that I released, I think, 3 years ago. Of course, it's going to be available. I just love the fact that now it's in, like, everybody's Christmas playlist. I feel like it's so fun, because, like, this is my favorite season, and the fact that my original song is now, like, it's playing across radio stations and in on Spotify playlist, I guess it's a good feeling for me. And I'm always, like, the first list that I always listen to is Christmas in Canada on Spotify Canada. It's, like, my go-to Christmas playlist that I first listen to, because it's, like, it showcases great Canadian artists, and it's just, like, a good mood to put up Christmas tree and, you know, to add lights and, you know, be happy.
Fantastic. Social media, place to go. Where do we go to follow you?
So Instagram, it's Maywells Official. Twitter, it's Maywells Music. Facebook, it's Maywells Official. YouTube is Maywells Official. So yeah, I guess the only one that wasn't that was already taken probably for the Maywells Official is Twitter. So Maywells Music on Twitter. But yeah, pretty much Maywells Official everywhere.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for making time to speak with me. And congratulations on the new
single. You are amazing. No, you are amazing. Thanks for letting me talk to you. It's always fun to chat with you. You always have, like, I'm going to give you flowers now, but, like, you always have the best question, and you're so, like, a must in our Canadian, like, music industry. So really, thanks to you. Like, I'm so looking forward to see, like, who you're going to interview, because I feel like you give time to, like, either, like, an independent artist or sign artist. So, no, thanks to you. Thanks for letting me talk to you.
You're welcome, and I bow to the queen. No, congratulations on everything that you're doing. And hopefully, you know, we did it. I think it was 2 summers ago when we actually did a one-on-one interview over in Toronto here at City Hall. Let's hope to God that maybe sometime in 2021 that could happen again.
Yeah,
you be safe. Big love. And we'll definitely talk again soon. What am I saying? You know, you and I are going to message each other on social media.
Yeah,
so.
For sure. Yeah.
All right.
We'll probably message each other, like, tomorrow or something.
Exactly. You take care and be safe.
You too. Bye.
Bye-bye.